For the first part of this project, we're going to need 8 rubber bands, 4 bunches of 12 diapers each, a container. This container is 7 inches and you can put in here comfortably 12 diapers. You can also choose a different type of container. Could be bigger, could be smaller. It is up to you. And this is what we'll do. Just like this. Like that. And then we put it inside. Like this. With this part inside and that part to the outside. Okay? And there we have it. We get a perfect circle. We're gonna put a rubber band around it. Make sure that the rubber band is hopefully halfway down, but as much as you can. You don't want it more than halfway down. And then I'm going to turn. Make sure that the rubber band is in the middle. Before I make adjustments, because there was a lot of space between this diaper and the other one, I wanted to minimize that as much as possible so they look as close as possible between one another. It doesn't have to be perfect because we are going to be covering this part, which is a wheel. I am going to use another rubber band just to make it tighter. And what I'm doing now is pressuring in so the wheel becomes tighter. Like that. And we got one wheel. Let's proceed to make the other 3 wheels. Once we have the 4 wheels, we're gonna put them on the side and continue. I have here, these are the rolls that go inside of the toilet papers. And these are the ones that go inside of the kitchen papers. When you choose your 6 rolls, make sure that they are all the same size. We're gonna need 6 plus 2, okay? And we are gonna need also some paper. And just counting 6 pieces of paper. And this is what we're gonna be doing with it. Once we have that, we put it inside. Like so. We're gonna do that with all of these ones. We have the 6 rolls done. Now we are going to use 3 pages of the newspaper for each one of these ones. All done. To continue, we are going to use a piece of cardboard. This is a cutting mat, and I have it here because I'm going to be cutting the cardboard, and I don't want to damage the vinyl underneath. What we need is four and a half by 14 and a half. 14 and a half by 4 and a half. Now it's cut. Perfect. Once we have these 2 pieces, we're gonna go back to this. I'm gonna put them in place like that, but so they stay, we're gonna use the double-sided tape. Okay. We're gonna try to put this in the middle, right in the middle. And I think that's okay, but if I wanna make sure, I can measure. Almost 3. And almost 3. Yep, pretty good. So now I'm gonna put the others. Like that. And now the same thing to this part. Ready? Turn and place it right on top like this. And it's gonna look like that on this side and like that on the other side. I want it to press so it's thick. I am going to use this tape, which is the regular tape, to secure this side. This tape is not as strong as the second tape that I use. You're gonna see it later in a minute or so. So what I will suggest you is that if you only have this tape, okay, use this one. But if you have a moving packaging tape, which is a stronger tape, just use the other one, which is the second one that I use. Once I am done with this, I am going to pass a little bit more tape because I just want to make sure that this one doesn't come off, that the tape is not going anywhere. Okay, I think I'm good. We are almost done with the base. Now, what I'm gonna do is cover the base with a nice paper tissue. I chose this pink color for the base. And I am going to need two sheets. So one and two. The first thing I'm gonna do with this sheet is that I am gonna fold it in half like this. And this leftover, I'm gonna fold it as well. Just wanna make sure that it fits this space here. So, just like that. Okay. Once I have it folded, I turn it. And then I turn again everything. And this will be the bottom, and this the top. The other piece of sheet I am going to fold this way, and again. Let's see. I just want to make sure that this part covers this part. I am going to use this very cute number 2, which is a balloon filled up with helium. I'm gonna cut it and use the material to cover the four wheels. I put it inside and I'm just gonna close the openings, which you see here and here. And the openings I am going to close with this tape, like that. I am gonna cut some of it because it's too long. Cut a little bit more. And I'm saying there is too long because I need to leave space in the middle here to create a hole to pass this right through here. Okay, this is the outside of the wheel, and this is the inside of the wheel, and right in the middle I am going to create a hole with the scissors there, introduce my finger into the hole and make sure that I can open enough space so I can put this part inside. There we go. That's good. The one thing that I need to do now is to secure this paper so it doesn't tear. So for that, I am going to use a little bit more of this tape. All around the middle. Wherever I don't feel the tape, that's where I need to put it. This tape will avoid any tear. Good. That wheel is done. For the next step, we are going to need a hanging lantern. This one is pink and is 16 inches in diameter. I will put in the description box a link to the lanterns. We're also going to use 10 diapers, 4 sheets of gift tissue in white, a glue gun with sticks, a baby pink craft felt. If you're not doing it pink, you can choose whichever color you prefer. The permanent double-sided tape, and also the moving packaging tape. Crowns made out of foam. Craft mesh tube in pink. A 1 by 2.5 piece of foam sheet in white. 2 metallic bead necklaces. And some decoration. I actually think that I may use a little bit of this paper as well. For the next step, we are also going to need a compass, a pair of scissors, a wire cutter, a pencil, and a ruler.